power? My father taught me one thing at a very young age, that Ruka, being a girl, when you get married, still I'm not, you would be going out anywhere in the world, and the only thing which a woman can carry with her is the knowledge. So knowledge is power, you should. And he saw to it that I got well educated. My mother told me a very good thing. She said, Ruka, wisdom is superpower. So I said that I got confused. My father is talking of knowledge and my mother is talking of wisdom. Then she put up a very good example that we all are taught, knowledge says that tomato is a fruit, correct? We all are taught that. But wisdom says that tomato cannot be put in a fruit salad. So, women do have a lot of that wisdom. So knowledge is power, then wisdom is super duper power. This part, then I'll go to some other part. Life is simple, then you get complicated. This is something somebody jailed me the equation on the left side. And I don't know what happened to me. And I made a new equation. If you guys can have a look at it. It is self-explanatory. So what I want to say, that either on the internet, on the Facebook, on your emails, you have a lot of SMSs or notes on this. But sometimes I would appreciate that if email can also give that touches and put things like that, which I did. I put it on my Facebook, I have 3,000 to 4,000 database of, you know, maybe 10,000 plus database of email IDs of my friends and whosoever come in touch with me. So I'm getting to all of them and I'm sure it must have become viral. So this is something which I would like to share with you. Now coming back to, I mean, after this, let's see what the next slide is. Okay. How many minutes I have? Just a minute. So long. That's going to be difficult now. Did I take out all the 7 minutes? I was given 7 minutes, no? Thank you. I can negotiate some more. Two, if they give me two, I'll take by myself. 4 minutes, fair enough. See, what I wanted to say here is that I have a lot of things to say, but I think we keep doing the Q&A. But what I wanted to say here is that talking about balancing of life, which is very important, not for men, also for, not for women, also for men, and especially for women, why? Because you know, you have to balance life in a very different way, like not just your personal and professional life. To be very honest, I'm very proud of my father. My father started his business from scratch. He was also in the social services, so he was the Home Guard commandant for the state of Ahmedabad, and he started his big business from scratch, and he had a young family to feed and to take care of them, and my father has done everything. So somehow, I to be very honest, I really don't know that whatever I hear from females and whatever they talk about men world, sometimes I consider that maybe I am not a woman or a person. I have never faced it. I'll tell you, I mean, if you talk of injustice done or things like that, I have struggles, if people talk of struggles, I don't think so. I have ever faced it all. Or I have never thought it that way that I'm facing some struggle or things like that. That is what I always tell people. When somebody tells me, okay, Ruzan, tell me about your struggles in life. I say, bullshit. I do not have any struggles in life and I do not want to glamorize the fact that there are struggles because I would never call them struggles in life. Because example, presumably that let's say that I had an ISP business where we had to put cables from building to building terraces to terraces. So now you go to the, many times due to some XYZ reason, you go to those terraces, you have to climb those terraces, climb those terraces. So many people would go, hey, you do this. I said, no, this is nothing. I'm not doing a big job. Everybody plans up the stairs. Everybody does that. So why? So I would never find a struggle. If I have to go and do my cold calls, I am a, as I used to call myself a technology person, but the demand required that I should also get into sales and marketing. I'm very close to sales and marketing. And in fact, everybody, even if she or she says that she doesn't know sales and marketing or she doesn't do sales and marketing, everybody at any point of time, even in the family, has to do sales and marketing and sell themselves or have strategies or do all branding. So let us not say that we don't do sales and marketing or we do marketing is not the thing. It just comes into it and you can call them, you can call it different names, but this I'm in sales and marketing. So what I want to tell is that ultimately at the end of the day, these all things, I mean, I'm very happy that you people are learning sales and marketing out here because unfortunately I never had the opportunity to do so and everything I learned, if I take it as a flip side, everything I learned, I learned it on ground, and so maybe that can also be helping because I didn't have to unlearn. Because I'm sure many times you guys would have to unlearn a lot of things when you got to business. Disoriented because of grammar. Fine, I wanted to say something else, but let me complete my size. I believe, and I'm a strong believer, manzil milti jayegi bhatakte hi sahi, ghumra ho hai jo ghar se nikle hi nahi. So, Bhakti, you can't listen for the things, let it not get motivated, inspired, depressed, whatever, but end of the day, you have to do this. This is a very, very important example I'd like to give you. Simple living, high thinking. And today's scenario is complex living, my father taught me simple living, high thinking. But today's scenario is complex living, confused living. Just a simple, fast example. And that is what, how can you say that? Just an example, and I'll especially keep a man character in this whole thing. So there's a man and a woman. Because this is their conference, that's one. There's a man and a woman, and they are into a husband and wife, and they are camping. So when they're camping one fine night, the wife wakes up the husband and asks him, "Hey, look what I'm seeing up." So the husband says, "I'm most impressed with the men, as they normally want to do." They say that, astronomically, I can see lots of galaxies and lots of planets and things like that. And she says, "Very good." She again asks, "What else do you see?" He says, theologically, God is great and see, he has built such a huge universe. Very good. He's strongly impressed. But again, ask him, what else do you see? He's wondering, he said, meteorologically, I'm seeing clear skies, so tomorrow's going to be a very good day. Now the husband has had enough. He uses all his gifts to impress his wife. He now doesn't have any more gifts. So then he asks himself, but what do you see? His wife says, I see that our tent is stolen. This is what I mean by simple living? You should not do? Confused thinking. And the men can't get into it. Well, there are a lot of examples for this, but I really know nothing. I'll take it up in the Q&A. Yeah, I'll do that. A lot of examples for this, and what is work? Okay. This is a very important thing I like to make. I'll give you one mantra that Manzil Mili Jayegi Bhatakte Hi Sahi. Second thing. I don't know if for this whole day, whatever you remember, not remember, enough clarity, enough uploading. But this is a simple exercise. You can do it right now also. Just think of any problem that you have in. Currently, you'll be facing any problem, or you think it's a problem, and think it as a challenge. Convert it into a challenge. Instead of using the word problem, say that it's a challenge for you. Okay? Or say that it's an opportunity for you. Do this mental exercise. Every time, now you should not have, I'm not talking something cliché that problems are never there, blah, 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 blah. Problems are always there, but how you convert them into challenges and opportunities. So let's say you say that this X thing is a big problem, instead of that, if you say X thing is a big challenge, just see your mindset, just see the frequency, just see the waves that you're getting. You will be getting very positive waves, which will help you to come up in life. Use that, take my words. This is going to be a vast difference in your life. Play a vast difference in your life. Heroes and heroes will never get defeated. This is my favorite dialogue, which I always tell people. Again, God by me. Everybody says, Dilara Dilara Dilara? Bada 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 Shara Ma Choti Choti? Bada Bada Rehti Hai. Signorita, right? I said, Bada Bada Shara Ma Choti Choti Hard Hoti Rehti Hai. That does not mean you should be okay. I think I'm done. Anyway. And Nanda Gani? Thank you. Sorry, I think I messed up a big time. Never mind. My favorite last dialogue is always Bharat Bhagya Vidhata. Thank you.